Hello friends, welcome to Inside Techs. This is a platform to learn about power transmission elements and its control system. In the previous video, we have seen how the current transformer three-phase wiring is done with the metering ratio of 300 by 111. Let us recollect that using this animated diagram. Here we have R, Y and B phase connected for metering, and as you can see, four wires coming out are D11, D31, D51 and D71, and all these four wires will go to the metering circuit in the panel using a 4-core 4 square mm cable. Now let us continue this video from here. And in this video, we are going to learn how these four wires are used in the panel inside the control room. Okay, so we have seen that there are four wires that are coming from the current transformer in the yard into the switch. The very first element that comes in the wiring is the TTV, that is test terminal block. Then another element is the KWH meter, that is energy meter. Then there is megawatt meter, then there is MVR meter and ampere meter to measure the current. How the connection is done for R phase, let us see that. From D11 we have one wire coming to TTB. From TTB we have a connection made to the energy meter, let us call that D12. Then we have another connection going into the TTB from energy meter, that is D13. Next, let us connect the megawatt meter. The wire is D14. D15 is the wire connecting megawatt meter and the MVR meter. Next, let us connect the ampere meter. The wire is called as D16. And then there is D71 that is coming out. The D71 is the common connection as we have seen in the previous video. Now you can see over here the similar way connections are done for other two phases, Y and B. Let us understand the importance of test terminal block. So test terminal block is useful whenever we want to do the testing of the energy meter. And also it is very useful when we want to work in the panel by removing the energy meter. Now let us understand how the current flows inside this circuit when energy meter is in service. The animation is shown over here for R phase. Similarly, you can also understand for yellow and blue phase. Now let us understand how the current flows into this circuit when energy meter is out of service. So through TTB you can see the use of TTB is that you can bypass the energy meter when you want to perform any testing of the energy meter. Now as we have seen in the video how the current is flowing from D11 and it is coming back into D71. So this is just an animation to show how when the D11 comes into the panel and again the current flows into the CT and you get back D71. Panel, see D11, here we have D11 and then D71 is coming back. And the current flows into the neutral and we get the neutral back. So you can see now starting from D11, the current has flown through the metering circuit inside the panel. It has come back through D71 in the neutral into the current transformer. And hence the complete circuit as you can see over here. Now similarly let us understand a three-phase wiring in for backup protection circuit inside the panel. Now we want to see the backup protection. So the connections are done as R2S1, R2S2, and similarly Y2S1, Y2S2, and for B phase. So here the four cables that are going into the control room will be C11, C31, C51, and C71. Let us understand now the wiring inside the panel. Inside the panel, you can see C11, C31, C51 and C71 that are coming from the CT in the yard into the panel. Now again we are having a TTB over here, and the connections are done from TTB into the overcurrent and earth fault relay. In normal condition, this is how the current is flowing into the overcurrent earth fault relay through the TTB from the wires coming from the current transformer. So now what happens when there is overcurrent or when there is some fault into the CT? So there will be more amount of current flowing into this phase. Now let us see how that occurs. You can see overcurrent or more amount of current is flowing in through the TTB into the relay. What will happen due to that? Due to overcurrent, a trip command will be sent to the breaker, and once the trip command is sent to the breaker, the positive meets the negative end and the circuit set complete, due to which the breaker will trip. Now let us move on towards the differential protection wiring inside the panel. So again we are back here, and for differential protection, the core we are going to use will be R3S1, R3S2, similarly for Y and B phase. And the four wires that will come out will be A11, A31, A51 and A71. Now let us understand this differential protection wiring circuit inside the panel. Okay, once the four wires reach up to the panel, then similar to previous wiring, there is a test terminal blocks through which A11, A31, A51 and A71 comes inside the panel and reach up to the differential relay. You can see in the differential relay, there is a connection from the LV side in which the current equivalent to the LV side will be already flowing. So what happens for the differential protection circuit is, whenever there is a normal current flow, as you can see, the normal current is flowing on the HV side. So when does a differential relay operate? A differential relay operates whenever there is a difference in the current flowing from HV side and LV side. So let us see what happens now. As you can see, there is more current flowing on the HV side. There is a difference of current from HV and LV, so due to which there will be a trip command sent to the breaker. Now due to which the positive terminal meets the negative, circuits get completed and the breaker is now tripped. Friends, there is one clarification to be made about how the current flows in a three-phase balance system. Whenever there is a three-phase balance system, the current will flow only through the three-phase. There is no current flowing into the neutral. Okay, so now what happens when the fault occurs? Whenever the fault occurs in any phase, the unbalanced amount of current will flow through the earth. See over here. Okay, so and whenever there is this unbalance occurring, due to which the tripping command will be sent to the breaker and the breaker will trip. So that's all for today's video, friends. Please let us know what you want to know in the next videos, what topic you want to learn in the upcoming videos, and keep watching our videos. Thank you.